Hi. I learned two astounding lessons this morning. I wanted to share them with you. One was I was at my photographer's house getting portraits done. She was having a portrait special today. And there was a photographer's assistant there with her, and I didn't know she had an assistant. And I was like, Alice, you made the thing happen that you wanted to have happen a year ago. When I met Alice a year ago and she became a client, one of her big things was, I want help. I want help with the stuff in my business. And she didn't know how to go about getting it. So we've been working on that. And if you ever check out any of Alice's work, you know that the work she does is impeccable and really detail-oriented. She has a lot on her plate. So I walk into her studio and there's an assistant there. And I'm like, you didn't tell me you had an assistant. And I just want to take a moment here and say, yay, bravo to all of us who say we want something, and maybe it takes us a year to get there, or maybe it takes us 5 years to get there, or 3 months to get there, but we say we want something and we chip away slowly, and boom, it happens. And sometimes you need somebody outside of yourself to say, hey, you did that thing. And so, this is first of all a love letter to my friend, client, and photographer, Alice, to say, you did that thing. I'm so proud of you. And I was talking to her assistant. Her name is Alex. Alex and Alice, it's very hard. And I said, Alex, how did you come to work with Alice? And she said, well, I moved to the town from this other town. And I basically, she didn't actually say opened up the yellow pages, but basically she opened up the yellow pages and started calling photographers and asked them if they needed any help. What a friggin' brilliant idea. And Alice took her up on it. And now she's got this great assistant. And the entire time I was in my shoot today, Alice was raving about how helpful having Alex there is, like how it's freed her up to do the things that really are her special sauce, the thing that she brings her magic to. And then Alex is learning a whole bunch of stuff about the business, about clients, about what it's like to deal with nervous clients, what it's like to deal with clients who aren't comfortable in front of the camera. So Alex is getting a whole education and also helping Alice, but she called her up and said, "Hey, do you need help?" And Alice could have said, "No, I can't afford anybody. No, I'm fine. I'll do it myself." But she didn't. She said yes. And so I wonder, you're probably stuck in some area of your life. I know this to be true because A, all of my clients are stuck in some area. In some areas, they're rocking it out, and in other areas, they're stuck. This is the nature of being a human being. And I am stuck in a certain area right now with my relationship with food. And so I have reached out to a woman who's happened to just come into my circle out of nowhere to talk about more intuitive eating. Hi, Jamie. And so I'm reaching out for help in a very specific area of my life. So if you guys think that because I'm a coach that I don't do my own work, like you're fooling yourself. I have plenty of areas in my life where I need to do a lot of work. So this girl, she's not a girl, she's a young woman. I'm sorry, Alex, you're a young woman. She called up somebody and said, can I help you? I want to learn. And somebody took her up on her offer. So somebody needed help and somebody offered help, and both of them got what they wanted by taking a huge risk. And I want to share this with you, this lesson, because it was so beautiful to sit back and watch the two of them interacting. And it was so lovely to see my friend Alice like light up with having this help and like be able to just do the thing in her zone of genius. And then to watch Alex be able to step in. And at one point, Alice says, Alex is now reading my mind. She knows what I want before I want it. And isn't that what we all need? Somebody to read our minds a little bit, somebody to step in and help us when we just know that we need a little help. So I wanted to come on and encourage you to do one of two things, or maybe both things, because there's somewhere in your life where you are rocking it out. Can you offer somebody some help in that area? And then there's another area of life where you feel a little wobbly, a little unsure. Can you ask for help in that area? It might not be easy. I'm sure that it will not be. But it will be life-changing. And it might not be life-changing in the next week. It might not be life-changing in the next month or the next 6 months. It might take you a year to see the fruits of the seeds you plant today. I want you to take a look around outside. It's blooming outside. It makes the sun is shining. It makes us so happy. Yes, I need my fortune teller ESP person. Jamie just wants to be told what she's going to do for the rest of her life. But it's blooming outside, and you deserve to bloom inside. And you either need to offer some help and be of service, because that's an amazing way to bloom, or you need to ask for help and get some service and get some help and get some support. And so I'm curious for you, which one of these resonates with you? Where are you rocking it out? Where are you totally blooming? Where are you super sunny? Where are your leaves blossoming and your flowers? Offer your help to somebody. And where are you feeling a little dormant? Where are you feeling like frustrated and dark and cloudy? Ask for help in that area. Until you ask for help, you are going to stay stuck. And sometimes it's the giving of help that will show you how valuable it is that maybe you could receive help. I hope this has been helpful to you. I just wanted to pop on quickly and say hi and tell you, first of all, you're normal. If at some areas of your life you're like this and in other areas you're like this, that is the human condition. So don't beat yourself up about that. Second, bravo to my client and my friend and my photographer, Alice, and her fantastic new assistant, Alex. And also, I wanted to encourage you to do something scary today, okay? What are you going to do that's scary? For me, it's always getting on Facebook Live, because Facebook Lives are scary, even if you've done 100 of them. I'm Jen Liddy. I'm a business development coach. I help women get their ideas out of their head and get a handle on their businesses so that they can have a life that breathes, that they can live, where they feel full. And I'd love for you to share this or follow me. And if you have any questions, please drop them in the comments, because you know that I will answer your questions. Bye.